So we will be talking about prehistory of Maharashtra, particularly the Paleolithic age. Now what is prehistory? Prehistory is first of all an age when there was no language and there was no metals or there was no pottery as such. So when we talk about prehistory and particularly the Paleolithic age, it itself is about stone age. So now what we do in prehistoric studies is the use of different sciences, in which first of all the prehistorians use anthropology, that is biological evidence, skeletal remains wherever it is available. Other than that, then we have archaeology, that is stone tools and particularly the artifacts of various stones as well as bones in some cases, and then environmental evidences, that is different markers, that is animal fossils, plant fossils, sedimentary record, climate proxies and other scientific techniques which are being used to study the prehistoric past of the humans. Now it is a study of human and environment together, that is prehistory or Paleolithic age. Now what we do in prehistory, what we learn are various issues, that is first of all human evolution, particularly for last 25 or 30 lakh years when humans have evolved through various species. Apart from that, we study the migration patterns of the humans from earlier origins from Africa going to Europe and Asia, the old world. We have migration patterns we study through prehistory. Then there are past life ways of the early hominins. So how they used to live and what they were adapting to the environment, these kinds of things we study in the life ways of the past hominins. Apart from that, we have technological developments of stone artifacts starting from the earliest, that is older one, going into Acheulean and then Middle Paleolithic and further so on. Then we have environmental studies related to past history, that is Paleolithic history. This is called as paleoenvironmental studies. So these are being carried out by archaeologists and various group of scientists all over the world, particularly old world. Then we have studies of climate change. We can see through various sedimentary records and environmental records, we can study climate change or past environmental changes through this study of prehistory and how it affected the human beings. Then we have, when we come into the later stages, we have art, early hominin or hominid period art, various art forms like rock arts or various kinds of rock arts or ostrich excel art or bead work, different kinds of art forms we have to study as part of prehistory. And then overall as a prehistory or history, we have to study early hominin or human behavior through only through the indirect record, that is stone artifacts or whichever artifactual record we have or pattern we have, through that we study the early hominin behavior. Now we can see the evolution of Earth as such. Now when we talk about Earth history starts about crores of years behind. But when we talk about human history, it is only about last 25 or 30 lakh years. So that is period known as Quaternary period. So now in that period, we have the hominins coming up using stone tools, making stone tools and using them and surviving through this period. So when we talk about humans, we are, if we consider as a Earth history as 24 hours, humans are only for last about 5 to 10 minutes, not more than that. So we are very limited time span of out of 24 hours of Earth history. So we have, but still when you consider about hominin history, this prehistory is the most number of time period which has been covered by early hominins, that is about 25 lakh years. So what kind of terminologies as in archaeology we use for prehistory? Now as we know that Paleolithic, that paleo means old and lithic means stone. So basically stone age, it is a stone age, and then Paleolithic itself is divided into three stages, that is old stone age or early stone age or lower Paleolithic, then we have middle Paleolithic, and then we have upper Paleolithic as such. So in lower Paleolithic, now when we talk about basic terminologies about prehistory, there are two basic factors. There are quaternary, that is geological time periods, and then there are archaeological terminologies. So when we talk about geological terminologies, we have quaternary period, as I mentioned earlier, that is about 25 lakh years, that is the core period for which prehistorians study, that is quaternary period. Within that we have divisions, that is Pleistocene, lower Pleistocene, middle Pleistocene and upper Pleistocene. Now lower Pleistocene or early Pleistocene is starting from about 18 lakhs and continuing about 7.8 lakhs. Then we have 7.8 lakhs to 1.3 lakh, that is middle Pleistocene, and then 1.3 lakhs to about 12,000 BP, that is late Pleistocene. So these time periods are very important while we study the prehistory of the humans. Then quaternary period, that is overall this period. Then we have paleoenvironmental studies as part of geological studies, climate changes through the time and chronology, geological chronology, and various roles of formation processes, that is rivers are flowing through, there are colluvium deposits, there are hill slope deposits. These are factors are considered in the geological time period terminologies. And then we have archaeological terminology, that is cultural sequences, as I mentioned earlier, lower paleolithic, middle paleolithic, upper paleolithic, all these things are as part of cultural sequence. Various typology, stone tools and various lithic types are there in these lower paleolithic, middle paleolithic and upper paleolithic. Then there are typological and technological studies of these stone tools. Then we have advanced techniques in these stone tools. And then human migration is also important part of when, how they evolved through these various time periods. That is also archaeological terminology. So there is a combination of geological terminologies and archaeological terminologies are used in prehistoric studies. Now there are various human species from Africa, Europe and Asia being reported. Now broadly there are divided into Australopithecus family, and then there are Homo family species. So in Homo family there are Homo habilis, Homo erectus, Homo neanderthalensis, Homo sapiens and Homo archaic sapiens, and these are still being studied and various species are still being coming up. So when we talk about prehistory of Maharashtra, we only talk about last 8 to 10 lakh years, and in that we have particularly Homo erectus on the basis of stone tools whatever we have found, that is Acheulean. We'll be talking about it later. So now about prehistory of Maharashtra, particularly how it is been divided in Maharashtra particularly, I will be talking about that. That is firstly it is Acheulean, lower paleolithic. It is basically large flake based tools, hand axes, cleavers and other stone tools like scrapers, and then there are debitas also. Then there is middle paleolithic, that is medium sized flakes, there are scrapers, points, borers, particularly flake based tools, and there is also blades. And then there is upper paleolithic, that is blade based technology, then burins and all. So you can see in these photographs. Then how the stone tools are made. So basically this is just a slide to show that hammer is being used to remove flakes from the core. So this is just a representation of that. Then what is typology? So how these tools are classified. So basically on the basis of that morphometry and their technological features, they are classified into various types. So just an example of various hand axes and cleavers. Now within these hand axes and cleavers and various types, there are subtypes as well, but broad types, these kinds of types are being divided while studying prehistory. Then there are various percussion methods or stone tool making techniques. So basic three techniques are being divided, that is direct technique, direct stone is hammered on another stone, that is direct technique. Then there is indirect technique, when there is punch is kept and above that it is hammered. And then there is pressure flaking. So these type of techniques are basic flaking techniques. And then there are subtypes and varieties in that also. Now coming into the prehistory of India as such. How prehistory commenced in this Indian subcontinent? It will be the last slide of this episode. Now there is a small history behind this. Now one Robert Brucefoot, a British geologist, he joined Geological Survey of India in 1860s, and while exploring in the southern part of India, he discovered lower paleolithic, that is Acheulean stone tools, at Pallavaram near Chennai on 30th May 1863. And after that he continued to survey in southern parts of India and other parts like Gujarat and all. So he discovered more than about 500 sites of paleolithic and neolithic and Iron Age period. So this is how the prehistoric studies or paleolithic studies commenced in India, followed by various studies by universities, various scholars and institutions in different parts of India. But as far as Maharashtra is concerned, or particularly Acheulean age in Deccan trap or basaltic region is concerned, very limited studies, or like about 70 to 80 years, there was a long gap. There was no studies carried out in this region. And major reason given was that this basalt bedrock or the Deccan trap rock is not suitable for making stone tools. So this was the reason given for early hominins not being occupied this region. So I'll be talking about this, how these studies came up in Deccan trap region in the next episode.